Good evening, everybody. This is Sangeeta Saxena, editor Aviation and Defense Universe, getting you live from Leh. We are at the Army Aviation Unit, and I have with me the CEO of the unit, Colonel Randeep Pathania. Welcome, Colonel Pathania, Radio's chat room. Wonderful to have you here. And what is happening here? We're seeing so many choppers here. So what is going on? Everybody is working on them.
Today it is happening here. We are planning a night flying. So before night flying, certain servicing is required to be done. So these technicians are doing that servicing. Post that, they'll offer the aircraft and we'll start off with a night flying. So before flying and after flying, servicing is required to be done. That is what is being done, carried out here.
And the servicing is being done by your people only?
Yes, are they all army personnel? Our technicians who are posted with us as an army person who are undertaking the servicing. We don't have any civilians or anyone. We have a small detachment of HAL who helps us in between.
Right. And do you take help from the MRO industry? Because there is a very major MRO industry in India, which is also...
We are totally dependent on HAL because these aircraft have been contracted through HAL.
Okay.
So we are dependent wholly and solely on HAL.
Right. And what are the types of choppers you have here?
Ma'am, we have an ALH, that is Advanced Light Helicopter, also called as Dhruv, which is what you are seeing right now. And there is a Cheetal unit also here. Cheetal is a modification of a Cheetah unit. Cheetah.
Right. And what is the sort of flying which happens? How many sorties? How much?
There are numerous sorties because the terrain is very difficult, time consuming for vehicles. There are a lot of posts which are cut out. The only way to go there is through helicopters, that is air maintenance. So multiple kinds of sorties we do. We do maintenance, we do troop induction, we carry out CASVACs, and also to do all that we need to do our training. So we do our training also to do all this.
Right.
So whatever we can think of a task which is required to be done by helicopter, which it can do, we are doing it here.
So training happens here only?
Training happens here only. The officers are posted initially. They undergo around 5 to 6 months of training before they are launched independent for the missions.
Right. And, you know, the technicians we have here, they get trained at HAL or they get trained with the Army only?
They are getting trained at Army. We have our school at Sikandrabad where they are trained. Then they are posted to various units. At the unit level also some part of training is carried out, which is called as on-the-job training. And then there are various courses and cadres which they undergo. And as a technician grows in service, he is firstly a technician, then he becomes first-line supervisor based on his experience and examination. Then he'll graduate to a senior supervisor. Then all the JCOs who are here, there are second-line supervisors. And on top of that, we are at engineering officers. So we have multi-layer of supervision involved here.
Right. And what is the sort of supply chain? How do you manage that?
Ma'am, we have a logistic officer posted with us. She's responsible. She's one of the officers. We've posted her as a logistic officer who through ordnance channel gets all that. So again, we are for a logistic dependent on ordnance.
For
all the helicopter space and everything. It is all through our army channel.
Right.
Ordnance contacts the HAL and through HAL, whatever is required, supplies are given to us.
Right. So is it a longish process? That suddenly you require something today, but then the process is long,
We have our spares so that the downtime of aircraft is reduced. We have adequate spares with us, and as and when assistance is required, it is given through HAL also.
Right, okay. And are there frequent inspections from HAL? Do they come and see? Do they visit?
Not frequent inspections. We have a small detachment of HAL here.
It's permanently here?
It is permanently here, who helps in certain technical aspects which are to be done by HAL technicians only.
Right.
And whenever help is required, that is a snag which is beyond the repair of this unit, we give a design disposition, we call for HAL technicians and they come and they do the repair in situ here.
Right. And normally you have Cheetals and then you have the ALH. Now, what is the sort of range the two of them?
We are able to cover the complete area of this.
Complete area. With both the choppers. There's no need for anything else. Any other chopper?
Definitely, no. Numbers always count. So more the numbers, better it is. But as of now, we are comfortable here.
Are we allowed to say how many numbers do you have here?
We have adequate, ma'am. The numbers keep varying.
Someone
will go into servicing, some are available. So there is no fixed amount of number, but we have adequate.
You have adequate. And what is the area? I mean, the area is the complete area under 14 core?
Yes, complete area under 14 core.
Okay.
We fly from Leh till around Siachen Heights, we cover Western Ladakh, we fly the complete Ladakh.
And the capacity to carry the payload is good, isn't it?
Payload is good. Definitely temperature has all aviation. Aspirants know that temperature, altitude has its effect. It has same on this, but it is doing its job.
And what about the fuel requirement?
Fuel requirement?
For the choppers.
We have our...
How do you manage that?
Supply provides us with the fuel here at least. We draw it from there. We have our pumps, storage capacity here. From there our bowsers draw the oil and it is given to us.
It's given to you.
Everything is here available. We are not required to go anywhere.
But this is this through civilian or is it through...
Again, through supply we are given it to us and they have contacted ahead to IOC.
Okay, right. And normally what is the strength of the officers here, officers and men? How big is the squadron?
It all varies. There is nothing is sacrosanct. Sometimes we have additional officers, posting outs are more than the number of officers reduces. So it is not a sacrosanct thing.
Right, and when you have winters and the snow sets in, what happens that time?
Happens that time because maximum cataracts will take place at that time. Roads are cut out, supplies are required to be dropped at that time. So the maximum flying for the unit actually will start post October.
Oh, okay.
And definitely it is a very tough place to operate.
Yes, absolutely. So,
but we have our ways and means and we do that.
Right. Thank you so much. It was wonderful speaking with you.